joining us. We're now in the shorter sessions part of our DevRoom program today. So this will be a 25-minute presentation. Again, if you do have to leave at any time, I invite you to go out the back door. It's a little quieter for our speakers. And so, without any other interruption, I'm pleased to introduce Stefan Hajnoczi from Red Hat, who will be talking about NVDIMM under KVM. Thank you, Stefan.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Stefan Hajnoczi. So I'm going to talk about NVDIMM under KVM. I've been contributing to QEMU for a while, mostly doing storage performance and tracing stuff, and Red Hat under KVM. But in the past year or two, there's been an effort to get NVDIMM emulation into QEMU. There's also lots of work in the Linux kernel. Around 8 gigs in-memory databases are kind of the most obvious and immediate thing that you want to do. You have some kind of a database, key value store, either something like memcache or something like Redis. And typically, people have added persistence nodes to these memory databases. But usually, they have limitations, the performance is not bad, kind of bolt on. And a lot of users actually run things like, you know, Redis without persistence or they don't trust it. And so it would be nice to get the persistence for free simply by putting in an NVDIMM on your machine. It's not true that you'll get it for free though, because you actually have to follow a specific programming model in order to access it. And I'm going to cover that in a little bit, but it's almost free, so it's pretty good. There are some other applications like databases or file systems, because what they have is they have transaction logs and other types of metadata. So what happens if you have to use the policy. I'm not sure about the implications. What I do know is that there are plans for having multiple things on machines, so specs, other things like that. So I'm guessing there's going to be some volatility, but I don't know what the benefits are.
More.
forget itself and stuff, so it means to convert subdivided. What it also means is that guest, when it messes with name spaces, it's only messing with its own name spaces. The guest has no way of accessing the name spaces of other VMs. So obviously there's some isolation there, which is necessary for security. And when you look at this, when you see all the layers, you probably think, okay, it was really fast and cool on bare metal. Now let me put it into KVM, because we've got all these extra layers that are probably really slow. The great thing is that that's not the case. When the whole stack is set up, and you have that map, even inside the guest, what the application map is virtual NVDIMM, it actually goes all the way back down to the physical NVDIMM. So that application, when it's being loaded to store, they are really going to the NVDIMM. There's no provider involved. So there's no extra layer running the names. I think the only other thing I should say is that on Linux, the current driver stack, you have to use the DevDAX devices. The Linux driver stack compatibility, it also offers a number of other types of devices, block devices that the drivers can instantiate on top of the NVDIMM, and not all of them support, you know, this full passive system memory. So things will be slower than DAX.
Get updated all the time, but it needs to be consistent, so that's also important.
so that's pretty much the end of my slides. I added links here depending on which layers you're interested in. There are specs, if you want to learn about hardware, there's code stuff, if you care about QEMU, there's documentation that's being merged right now. That's only been like that command line documentation that shows you how do I create an NVDIMM. I didn't show it to you in this presentation, but there are command line options you need to use. Basically,
laptops. I'm just wondering if the NVDIMM, since it contains the DIMM component, can be used as a regular memory, actually, with basically be safe for power failure in a normal sense, not in a VM.
Bothers me as well because Linux applications does not